Conception rates when using artificial insemination can be severely reduced if semen is not handled properly. Proper semen handling requires being comfortable with a liquid nitrogen tank, so you can work quickly and efficiently to avoid damaging frozen semen.
A liquid nitrogen tank is a double-walled container in which two tanks are fused together with a fiberglass neck. A hinged lid covers the tank canister area, and a styrofoam cork fits loosely in the tank neck. Stainless steel canisters hold the semen canes in the tank and have handles that rest on the outside of the tank. The neck of the tank is labeled with a number where each canister handle rests. These numbers allow you to identify each canister and develop an inventory of the semen each canister contains. Keeping a frequently updated inventory can help you find the straw you want to retrieve in a timely manner. Having a detailed map of where specific bull semen is located can help you quickly identify which canister the desired straws are in. This can help prevent repeated lifting and raising of canisters while finding the semen you are looking for. Semen is packaged in half or quarter cc straws with 5 or 10 straws per goblet and 2 goblets per cane. The top of the cane is marked with the cane code to identify the bull, and it may also include the bull's common name. Keep the neck plug in place and the lid closed on the tank until you are ready to retrieve the straws for thawing. Raise the canister until the cane tops are a few inches below the tank's opening. Do not raise a canister above the frost line. We recommend that the canister not be raised into the neck of the tank for more than 8 seconds when removing straws or looking for the right cane. If 8 seconds has passed, lower the canister back into the tank to ensure the straws remain fully frozen. After identifying the cane you want to remove the semen from, straighten the identification tab if this has not already been done. This allows easier access to the semen straws in the goblet. Raise the desired cane while lowering the canister slightly. Lowering the canister places the rest of the semen lower in the tank, which is colder. Use tweezers to remove the semen straw. It will take some practice to become comfortable with this movement. Remember that your fingertips are a heat source and should not be used to grasp the semen straws. After the semen straw is removed, you should raise the canister slightly. Return the cane to the canister and lower the canister back into the tank. To avoid losing canes within the tank, it is important to ensure the canister is raised partially into the neck of the tank before releasing the cane. At no time should the canister be raised above the top of the frost line. When you have used all the straws in the top goblet, remove it with a pair of tweezers. There could be some liquid nitrogen in the goblet, so use care when discarding it. When you have used all of the semen in a cane, discard the empty cane. Before retrieving a straw, ensure a thaw bath is prepared at the correct temperature. As a general rule, straws should be thawed in 96 degrees Fahrenheit water for a minimum of 45 seconds. Other thawing procedures may be acceptable depending on the extender used. Check with the semen company for details. If using an electronic water bath, make sure the unit is turned on and has reached the correct temperature before using. Use a thermometer to confirm the temperature of the water before inserting a straw of semen. Occasionally, these units may need calibration to keep the water at the recommended temperature. Once a straw is thawed, it is critical to maintain it at approximately 96 degrees Fahrenheit until deposited in the cow. We recommend that straws be deposited into the cow within 10 minutes of thawing. Multiple straws can be thawed at once, but attention to detail is critical when thawing multiple straws in the same thaw unit. First, it is critical to keep straws identified within the straw bath to avoid confusing or using the wrong straw. Second, Straws should not stick together in the thaw unit, as this can cause uneven or incomplete thawing of straws. Third, use caution as to the number of frozen straws placed into the unit at any one time. Each straw is essentially an ice cube that can result in a temporary cooling of the water in the thaw bath. In general, we recommend thawing no more than 3 straws at any one time. AI guns must be warmed before semen straws are inserted to ensure sperm survivability. To warm the gun, place it inside your shirt until you are ready to load it. Sheaths can also be tucked into your shirt to keep them warm if it is cold outside. When ready to load an AI gun, pull the plunger on the AI gun back about 6 inches to allow for the insertion of the straw. Remove the straw from the thaw unit with tweezers and place it in a paper towel. While keeping the straw protected from sunlight, dry the straw thoroughly. The paper towel also protects the straw from ambient temperature and wind. Using scissors or a straw cutter, cut a 1/4 inch below the sealed end of the straw at a 90-degree angle. Insert the cotton plug end of the straw into the AI gun and slide the plastic sheath over the gun. Most sheaths are designed with a tip that will lock into place to prevent backflow. It is important to ensure the sheath is secured on the flange of the AI gun. Once you have loaded the AI gun, insert it into your shirt to keep the semen warm and out of direct sunlight. Remember, we recommend that semen be deposited into the animal within 10 minutes of thawing. Make sure that the animal is locked up for AI and work efficiently when a loaded gun is prepared.